Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss about music therapy or the magic of music. Music is an important part of our life as it is a way of expressing our feeling as well as emotions, right? Sometimes people consider or some people consider music as a way to escape from the pain of life, and it gives us a relief and allows us to reduce our stress. So, we can say music plays an important or major role in our life than just being a source of entertainment. So, music is playing a major role in our life to reduce the pain. And in this video, we are going to discuss how this music therapy will work and how this music therapy will help to alleviate the tension, stress and suffering, and how it will improve happiness. Music therapy is a type of therapy which used to improve and maintain the physical, psychological and social well-being of individuals. Music therapy involves different activities such as listening to music, singing music and playing musical instruments. So don't think that music therapy means just listening music. It involves a group of activities like listening to music, singing music, playing a musical instrument. And music has been used as a therapeutic tool for centuries and has been shown to positive effect on brain, including the regions involved in emotion, cognition, sensation and movement. This fact made music therapy is an effective treatment of physical and mental problem. So, music therapy is a type of therapy or it is a type of treatment which used to improve and maintain the physical, psychological and social well-being of individuals. While coming to the history, we can say Michigan State University in 1944 began music therapy course and included music therapy as a part of curriculum. In 1950, the first major professional organization for music therapy was formed and it became known as National Association for Music Therapy. In 1998, the American Music Therapy Association was formed to increase the awareness of and access to music therapy services while promoting the advancement of education, training, professional standards and research in the field of music therapy. So, it's clear that we can do a lot of things in the field of music therapy like education, training, professional standard maintenance and research in the field of music therapy. There are a lot of changes are happening in our brain and body while listening music that we are going to see now. Listening music will help to release dopamine. It's a hormone which creates a feel-good feeling in our body. So, music will help to release this dopamine. Strong beat music or fast beat music can stimulate the brain waves and improve concentration. So, fast beat music can improve our concentration. At the same time, slow beat music will give meditative stage to mind and body. So overall, this music will soothe in our mind and it will alter pain and depression to different pattern. This music also improve our heart rate and breathing and reduces the perception of pain. So music is playing different roles and music is doing lot of changes in our brain and body while listening different type of music. How music affect different areas of brain? Now we are going to see that. Motor cortex, this area of brain involving in movement and dancing while playing music. Next is prefrontal cortex. This area will control our behavior and decision making while listening music. Amygdala, this area will control or deals with emotional reactions or response to music. Auditory cortex, this area will helps to listen and analyze music sounds and tones. Sensory cortex, this area will control the feedback while playing instrument, and hippocampus, it's another area, will help to memorize the music context and experiences. Visual cortex, it involved in reading music, and cerebellum will control all the movement while playing music and emotional reaction. So, in this way, different areas of brains are getting changed and controlling the music while listening music. Now we are going to see the indications of music therapy, or in which are all the condition we can use this music therapy to reduce the stress and tension and also enhance the feeling of relaxation. So music therapy we can use in depression, in mood problems, in anxiety problems, schizophrenia, substance abuse, autism, personality problems, cancer, hypertension, labor time, stress and coping problems. In all these conditions, we can use music therapy as an effective type of treatment or effective type of treatment or therapy to reduce the stress, reduce the pain. So simply we can say that music therapy can both assess and enhance cognitive, social, emotional, motor functions and psychological problems. Music therapy can be generally divided into two techniques. They are active techniques and receptive techniques. Now we are going to see what is active technique and what is receptive technique. When a person is making music, whether by singing, chanting, playing musical instruments, composing, improvising, or the person is using active technique. So while making music, the person is using active technique. Second thing is receptive technique. This involves listening to and responding to music such as through dance or analysis of lyrics. So while listening music, we are using receptive techniques. Then in the therapy session, we will use both techniques, or we will combine these both techniques to provide effective music therapy. Music therapy can be conducted with individual or in group. We can give to a particular individual or we can conduct it within the group. Therapist will select the lyrics and music based on the mood and psychological state of the person. That's very, very important. Always the therapist must concentrate on this. Therapist must select the lyrics and music based on the mood and psychological state of the person. When a person experiences difficulty in communicating, music therapy like melody music can enhance speech production and fluency. That's a really important thing. When we have difficulty in communicating due to some emotional problems, due to some pain or tension, music therapy like melody music can enhance speech production and fluency. So definitely we have to listen music if you have some pain or tension. It will help to increase or enhance the speech production and fluency. Music therapy can improve the motor skills by playing simple melodies on a piano or tapping out a rhythm on drum pads. Listening to rhythmic stimulus can also help a person to initiate, coordinate the time and movement. Person with autism can develop or strengthen the emotions by listening music. And music therapy can incorporate with progressive muscle relaxation techniques to enhance the effectiveness of this method. So music therapy will help to enhance the speech production. It helps to improve the motor skill. It helps to improve the coordination. It helps to strengthen the emotion. And also we can use along with other kind of treatment modalities to increase the effectiveness of that methods. Group drumming music. It means group members sit in a circle with a hand drum while the therapist leads them in drumming activities. The group members will drum one at a time or all at once. Therapist will ask some questions during the time of drumming. For example, like how they feel by playing a rhythm on their drum, which will help the therapist to understand the mood of the patient and also helps to improve the group cohesiveness. So group drumming is a type of music therapy, and in this therapy, all the members will drum at a time or all at once, and therapist will ask some question during the time of drumming or doing the procedure, and that will help the therapist to understand the mood of the patient and also it improve the group cohesiveness. Now we are going to see the limitations of music therapy. Of course, there are some limitations. Music therapy produces positive results, but it is not useful alone for the treatment of serious medical and psychiatric issues. Okay. Music therapy is useful, but it is not useful alone for the treatment of serious medical and psychiatric issues. We have to give specific treatment for specific key cases. Along with that, we can provide this music therapy. patient's preference is very, very important. Not all individuals will find each type of music to be therapeutic. So it all depend upon the patient and preference of patient. Some music forms may actually cause agitation. So music therapists must do a keen observation to ensure the musical preferences of the individual in the treatment modality. That's very, very important. So these are all considering as the limitations of music therapy. Now we are going to see some research results. How we can ease the anxiety and discomfort during the procedure. How this music therapy will reduce the anxiety and discomfort during the procedure. Procedure in the sense medical procedures. Researchers are saying that in controlled clinical trials of people having colonoscopies, angiographies or any kinds of surgeries, those who listened to music before their procedure had less anxiety and less need for sedatives. That's an important point. So, people who listened to music in the operating room reported less discomfort during their procedure, and people who heard music in the recovery room used less analgesic medication for pain. So, the researchers is telling that in this way, music therapy can reduce the anxiety and discomfort during procedures. It can also help in physical therapy and rehabilitation process. A 2011 analysis of several studies suggests that music therapy enhances people's physical, psychological, cognitive and emotional functioning during the rehabilitation programs. And music therapy decreases pain perception, reduces the amount of pain medication needed. That's what I've told you. It will alter the perception and it will reduce the perception of pain. And it will help to improve the quality of life for the people with dementia. The researchers are also telling that or saying that this music therapy improving the quality of life for people with dementia. So we can say that music therapy can help to evoke memories, to reduce agitation, assist communication and improve physical coordination. While coming to depression, a systemic review published in 2070 found that studies have shown music therapy can be an effective component of depression treatment. So, in depression treatment, we can use music therapy as an effective treatment. The result of the research says that the use of music therapy was most beneficial to the people with depression when it was combined antidepressants and physiotherapy or psychotherapy. So, when we combine music therapy with antidepressants and psychotherapy, it is most beneficial. And the researchers are telling that music therapy was most beneficial to the people with depression when it was combined antidepressants and psychotherapy. Journal of Affective Disorder Study in 2015 described that when used in combination with other forms of treatment, music therapy may help to reduce OCD thoughts, that is obsessive compulsive thoughts, and anxiety in people with depression and obsessive compulsive disorder. So, music therapy is playing a lot in depression to reduce the OCD thoughts and anxiety. In 2016, researchers conducted a feasibility study that explored how music therapy could be combined with cognitive behavioral therapy, that is CBT, proved that music therapy is an effective option for treating mild to moderate depression symptoms. So the researchers is saying that music therapy is playing a major role in treatment of depression. While coming to insomnia, insomnia means what? Loss of sleep. Researchers have shown that music therapy may be helpful for people with sleep disorders or insomnia. When we compare to prescribed treatments by doctor, music is less invasive, more affordable, and something as a person can do on their own to self-manage. That's an important and very important point that we have to notice. When we compare to prescribed treatment by doctors, music is less invasive, more affordable, and something a person can do on their own to self-manage. So specific techniques like music-assisted relaxation therapy have been shown to benefit in people with sleep difficulties. And studies also shown that Music can be a non-pharmacological treatment for insomnia in hospitalized patients. So in the case of insomnia also, music therapy is really helpful. Well, coming to pain management, research has shown that better results from listening to music while healing from surgery or an injury. The Journal of Complementary Therapies in Medicine in 2015 published a study which says that in post-operative hospital care, music therapy was an effective way to lower pain levels, anxiety, heart rate, and blood pressure reading in patients who were undergone thoracic surgery. So, in pain management also, this is playing a major role. A Scandinavian study published in 2017 found that children and teens who listen to music with headphones during minor surgical procedures showed fewer post-surgical maladaptive behaviors for up to a week after surgery. And music helps in pain management during labor and childbirth also. A 2019, that means a recent review of literature conducted by Sydney MOHR Lawrence University, found that childbirth associated with music therapy appears to be a positive, accessible, non-pharmacological option for pain management with benefits for laboring mothers and newborns. One study found that when music was added to the standard neonatal pain management during heel prick blood test, the premature infant's facial expression and vital were noticeably different. Vital in the sense vital signs. So, study found that music was added to standard neonatal pain management during small blood test and all. The premature infant's facial expressions and their vital signs were noticeably different. The premature babies who were exposed to music had lower heart rate and different facial expressions while listening music. The researchers concluded that music could be an effective method to pain management in neonatal intensive care unit, similar to how it can be used with adults. So, there is a magic of music we can see irrespective of the age. In chronic pain management also, music therapy is giving better results. Music tone connections to memory will help people to focus on positive memories. Cancer. Music therapy is playing a major role to reduce anxiety in cancer patients who start chemo and radiation treatment. And also it helps to reduce the side effects like nausea after chemotherapy and radiation. So in the case of cancer also, music is playing a major role to reduce the pain while starting chemo or after chemo and after radiation, and also to get rid of the side effects. Music therapy also helpful in many conditions like schizophrenia, speech disorders, behavioral disorders, cardiovascular diseases, substance use disorders or substance abuse, autism, PTSD, that is post-traumatic stress disorders, developmental problems, stroke, brain injury and neurological disorders. So in many things, many cases, music therapy is giving positive effect and positive results. So we can conclude that music is a human phenomenon. It is a sensory experience that can activate or stimulate all areas of brain at the same time. This creates powerful new potentials for the development of new neuronal pathways. Music therapy is useful because music triggers whole brain process and functioning, which directly affects one's cognitive, emotional and physical functions and abilities. So music is playing a major role in our life, and music will helps to reduce pain, suffering, tensions, and it also enhances a feeling of happiness. Hope you understand this session. Thank you.